The dengue virus is a mosquito-borne virus that infects over 100 million people each year, and there is currently no vaccine available to prevent this infection.
The common name for the virus is called breakbone fever, and that's actually a really good description of how the virus makes you feel. I imagine all the things that happen to you when you get sick with a cold, for example. You begin to sneeze, you cough, sometimes your body temperature goes up, and these are all adaptations of the immune system to beat out a disease organism. So your body does the same thing. It basically goes through a fever to elevate body temperature and kill off the pathogen.
Although there is no cure for the dengue virus at this moment, scientists such as Shannon are researching the virus in order to gain a better understanding of the virus and how it infects humans.
The virus is an enveloped virus, and it's got a lipid bilayer that's coating the virus genome. It's kind of like a bubble or a droplet. And on the outer surface of that bubble are proteins, and those proteins are actually binding to host white blood cells. So the white blood cells are meant to bind to those, and they bind to the virus and they engulf the virus into what we call a phagocytic vesicle, where it's going to slowly digest the virus. But the virus has tricked out the human immune system in that instead of being digested in the phagosome, it actually activates the virus's proteins to open up a pore into the host cell, into the cytoplasm, and then the virus spills into the host cell.
The dengue virus is mostly found in tropical areas where mosquitoes thrive. It recently appeared in Florida in 2009. As scientists are racing to find a cure and to create a vaccine, there are precautions you can take when you travel to areas where the dengue virus is prominent.
I always tell people to look to their own environments and be responsible in terms of your encounters with mosquitoes, because the more you encounter mosquitoes, the more likely you are to encounter an infectious disease that's transmitted by them. So I always warn people to look around them and empty any potential water sources on their property or in their homes, in their gardens, that where the mosquitoes might breed. I try to wear long sleeves and long pants to protect myself from mosquito bites.